Welcome back to the course. In the previous video, we saw that how we can make our Raspberry with the camera ready for image capturing. So we assemble the Raspberry, we enable the camera module or camera ports enable, plus the SSH port that we will see why we did it in the next video. And so we are ready for image capturing. So for image capturing on Raspberry, we can write a couple of script to make it enable for image capturing. So we will start from beginning, how we can just capture one image. So and we can define any resolution to that, and we will see how we can do this. So for that, you just need the new file with the extension of py as a Python script, and then inside the file you can write these couple of lines, and then you will capture an image. So it's an easy task. So okay, we will see that at the beginning we should import two libraries. The first one is the time library, so we need it if when we wanted to make such a break, or we can say that sleeping time for the camera. And then the Pi camera is the library for camera, Raspberry camera or Pi camera. So we can use the camera. So we can say that from the library, we will import the Pi camera, and we assign it as the camera, the name of that. And then we can define a resolution. So here in this case, we have the resolution of 1024 and 568. So we can reduce this resolution, we can increase this resolution. It's based on your purpose that you wanted to say, but we consider that when we reduce the resolution of image, so we have the small parts of your view on that. So we should know that what is the distance between your object and your camera, and what is the angle of view of the camera. You should know about this, and then you will define a good resolution parameters for image resolution, for camera resolution. So, and then we just use the start preview to see the view of the camera before capturing an image. So you can avoid from this if you know that it is well defined, but anyway, I recommend you to use the start preview, and then you can consider a sleeping time. So if you want to change the position when you are looking at the position of the camera, you can define for example, a sleeping time instead of 2 seconds, for example, 20 seconds, and you have time to adjust your camera based on the position of your object. So, and then after this time, sleeping time, we can have this line of camera.capture. We can define a name for this, your first image, .jpg. This can be that PNG or any extension that you want, and then it will capture an image and will save it on the Raspberry. So, and then after that we will stop the preview, so we don't have the screen for the camera. So this is just a couple of simple Python lines to make your camera enable for image capturing. But sometimes you wanted to get benefit of the maximum resolution of the camera for your work. That is this one, 2592, and 1944. This is the maximum resolution of the normal camera, the Pi camera that you usually buy. So of course that you can buy another type of cameras for the Raspberry, such as fisheye cameras, stronger cameras with more zoom capability or adjustable zoom. So, but anyway, in the normal situation that you are buying the the camera V2, the Pi camera V2 version 2 for this. This is the maximum resolution that you can get from the camera. If you go for this resolution, we also should define the frame rate. The frame rate is the time that it will take between each seri of the image that the camera will take. For example, if you have a look at the catalog, you see that, for example, it's written that it is 30 frame per second, so it can take 30 frame in 1 second. So, but when we go for the maximum resolution, we should define it as a 15. So it should be considered for this part, and the rest is the same as the previous one. Okay, so the starting preview, sleeping time, and then capturing the image, and then we will stop it. So you can also play with other parameters of camera. For example, for the brightness, you can change the parameter for the brightness. If you go to the it should be between 0 and 100. If you go for the number of 100, you are at the maximum brightness, so it will be a white your image. And if you go for the minimum brightness, that's the 0, your image will be fully black. So, and also there are other parameters for the camera. For example, you can use the contrast. You can adjust the contrast based on your scene. You can use annotate text to add a text or a phrase to your image. And you can use also the color. So you should write camera.color. If you wanted to have, for example, the blue background, if you want to, for example, red background, or you want to play or adjust the color in our image. And there are several other parameters that you can use for your code. So the next step is the time that you wanted to have a time lapse. For example, you are in the greenhouse and you wanted to monitor your plant every, for example, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, or 20 minutes. It can be a time lapse for 1 day, 2 days, and so on. So in that case, you cannot just write the script to take one captured image and finish. So you have to make the configuration for a time lapse. Okay. So in that case, you will use the same libraries, but and also here you will also enter the library as the name of the camera. So the same as the previous one, you can have the start preview and then the sleeping off of 2 seconds. And then here, instead of having just camera.capturing that we saw in the previous script, we can use capture continuous, and then we will define a name for this. We will define a counter here, because if we just use one name for our image, for the second time it will overlap on the first image. The third image will overlap on the second image. We have overlapping problems, so we consider a counter here to just randomly go as a counter and save an image, such as image 1, image 2, image 3, and so on. So, and then we can also, if you want, you can on the terminal, you can print that this is the captured, for example, captured the first image, captured the second image, and any name that that you want to have. And then this is the place that we should consider for the time lapse. So here, as I said, also here we saw that we use the time that asleep for the 2 seconds. But here we can use, for example, 300 seconds. That will be equal to 5 minutes. So your time lapse will be 5, or we can call it the frame rate. It will be also 5. So it's a captured image every 5 minutes and will save on your Raspberry. So you can leave it for a week or for a month, but you also should consider that your memory stick should be big enough or large enough, the capacity of the memory stick, I can say, large enough to save all of this, because each image in the normal resolution, default resolution, that is the 1098, I think, by 768, the size is around 2.3 mega. So, but of course that it's also depend to the to your scene. So, but you should also consider this important factor, or you can also add an external a hard disk to your Raspberry and save it on the external hard disk. But you should be careful about this. Okay, so that's enough for this video. In the next video, I will show you how we can assemble the Raspberry. So here in the slides we saw, and in the next video, in the real world, we will see how we can assemble it, Raspberry, and run such a disk codes in the Raspberry. Okay, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.